So the title of this experiment is Wheatstone Bridge. So this Wheatstone Bridge is mainly used to find out the unknown resistance. Okay. So now in this experiment, so we will verify two cases. In the case one, when the bridge is balanced condition. In the case two, when the bridge is in unbalanced condition. So when the bridge is in balanced condition, so this is used to find out the unknown resistance. In the case 2, when the bridge is in unbalanced condition, it is used to find out the current values. Now we will see these two cases separately. Okay. So first see the circuit diagram. Okay. So here you just take four resistors R1, R2, R3, R4. Okay. So better any values you can take, but better you take R1 10K, R2 10K and R3 you can take DRB. Decade resistance box, it is a variable resistor, and it is R4. For the time being, you just assume R4 as unknown resistance. So that's why you take R4 is equal to Rx, means it is unknown resistance value. Okay, now first in the balanced condition, now here across these two terminals, you just connect a galvanometer. So across these two points, you just connect a galvanometer, and in between these two points, you just give some power supply. So power supply, any power supply you can give, better you can give 5 volts of DC power supply in between these two points. So this is a circuit diagram. Now in the balanced condition, so first take R1 is equal to 10K, R2 is equal to 10K, R4 is equal to 10K, and R3 you just take DRB. Okay, in the DRB means it is a variable resistor value. So initially your DRB you set to some value. So R1 is equal to 10K, R2 is equal to 10K, R4 it is also denoted with Rx, it is unknown resistance. For example sake, we can take this also a 10K. Okay, now theoretically, so here galvanometer is there, when this is called Wheatstone bridge. So this bridge will become balanced bridge when the product of opposite resistors will be equal. So here you can take R1 into R4 should be equal to R2 into R3. So this is a condition for a bridge to balance. Whenever the bridge is balanced, here in the galvanometer it will show null detection. Whenever the galvanometer shows null detection, it is a meaning that the bridge becoming balanced condition. So for the balanced condition, the condition is opposite resistors product should be equal. R1 into R4 should be equal to R2 into R3. This is the condition for the balanced bridge. Now in the case 1, when the bridge is balanced condition, we will see how to measure unknown resistance value. So this is the tabular column for case 1. So here you can see R3. So first R3 is nothing but this one. It is a variable resistor. So that's why better you take DRB in place of R3. Next practical Rx. Rx means this one. This is R4. Okay. Next this one, theoretical Rx. Okay. Now here what we will see, we will take some different resistor values for this R3. And for each resistor, first we will connect, we will find out the R4 value by using formula, this formula. Actually, what is the formula here? So when the bridge is balanced condition, R1 into R4 should be equal to R2 into R3. So here you can see here, Rx is equal to R2 into R3 by R1. This is the formula. So based on this formula, if you can find out the Rx value, that is called theoretical value. So here, first, for the easy of convenience, you take R1 is equal to 10K, R2 is equal to 10K, R4 is also 10K. So it's not compulsory that you have to take only these values. You can take any values, but for the easy of calculation point of view, you can take R1 is equal to 10K, R2 is equal to 10K, next R4 is equal to 10K. DRB, you just take R3, you can connect DRB here. Okay. So now we will start the experiment here, you can see. So first, you set some value for this R3. It is 10K, it is 10K, it is also 10K. So R3, you can set some other value here. Okay, so one second. So you can have this table. This is R3 and this is Rx it is theoretical, theory. And this is Rx, it is practical. It is practical. So this is a table. So first initially I have taken R1 is equal to 10K, R2 is equal to 10K, R4 is equal to 10K. Okay, R3 DR. So now suppose here, since R4 is equal to 10K, so first let me take R3 is equal to 10K. When R3 is equal to 10K, here you can see R1 10K, R2 10K, R4 10K. So obviously, whenever the DRB is adjusted to 10K, then only you will get the balanced condition. So why? Because R1 into R4, 10 into 10 should be equal to R2 into R3. R2 also I have taken 10K. So while adjusting this DRB, so this is R3 value, when this R3 reaches 10K, then only the galvanometer will show null deflection. Means the bridge is becoming balanced condition. So that's why R1 10K, R2 10K, R4 10K, when adjust R3 to 10K, then you will get the balanced condition. So that's why, so R3 is equal to 10K. When R3 is equal to 10K, what is theoretical Rx value? So here, what is theoretical Rx value? Here you can see R3 into R2. You can see R3 into R2 should be equal to R1 into R4. So from this, we want R4 value. Okay. So R4 value, R4 is equal to R3 into R2 by R1. This is the formula to calculate R4 value. R4 value is nothing but Rx, our unknown resistance. So here R3 10K, R2 10K, R1 10K. You will get some resistor value. So this is theoretical value. Now, practically, what is the value of this one, R4? Okay, so these two should be match. Then we can tell that for this R3 of 10K, theoretical value of Rx, we will get something, some value here. So 10 into 10 by 10. So R4 is equal to 10K. This is a theoretical value. Theoretical value means by using this formula, what amount of resistor value will come for this R4, that is a theoretical value. We have to match this theoretical value with practical value. So what is the practical value actually R4? R4 also I have taken 10K. So that's why the practical value of RK is equal to 10K. So this 10K matches. So like that you take some other value. Next R3 is equal to, you take 20K. Okay. So for this, according to this formula, you find out R4 value and you just verify whether it is matches or not. Like that, you can take some different values for R3 and different values for R4. You can verify these two. So mainly, so this is used only to find out the unknown resistance value. Okay. So according to this balanced condition, so you can find out the unknown resistance value. Okay. So this is the case one. So this is the case one. In the case one, that is called balanced condition. In the balanced condition, Wheatstone bridge is mainly used to find out the unknown resistance value. Okay. Now, we will go for unbalanced condition. Now, we will see the case two, that is called unbalanced condition. Okay. So in the unbalanced condition, mainly this circuit is used to find out the current values. That we will see how. Okay. Now, same circuit you can take R1, R2, R3, R4. R3 variable resistor, you can take DRB. Okay. Now, here R1 10K you can take, R2 10K you can take, R4 also 10K you take. Any other values you can take, no problem. For the easy of calculation point of view, I have taken these values. Okay. Now R3 is DRB. So you can connect to DRB. So DRB, okay. This one, R1 10K, R2 10K, R4 10K. Okay. Now, in order to have the unbalanced condition, so since R1, R2, R4 are 10K, R3 value should be other than 10K. So if R3 value is set to other than 10K, any value, then the bridge will become unbalanced condition. Whenever the bridge is in unbalanced condition, galvanometer will show some current value. Whenever the bridge is in balanced condition, galvanometer will show null deflection. Whenever the bridge is in unbalanced condition, galvanometer will show some current value. So that is a current value. So here 10K, 10K, 10K. So that's why you R3 value, you can take some other value other than 10K. So for example, say here I am taking R3. This is a table, current, theoretical current, next a practical current. Okay, now when R3 is equal to 8K, for example, say any value you can take, R3 is equal to 8K. So first, theoretically, what is the current value, we will calculate and we will write here. And for practically, what the galvanometer is showing, that is a practical value that we have to write here. These two values should be match. Okay, now theoretically, how to calculate this current value, you can see the formulas. So here you can see, this is the formula. So mainly the formula is, the current, galvanometer current IG is equal to VTH, Thevenin's voltage, divided by RTH, Thevenin's resistance, plus RM. RM means galvanometer internal resistance. This is the formula. So how to calculate this VTH means, this is the formula. VTH is equal to E into R4 by R4 plus R2 minus R3 by R1 plus R3. So here E is nothing but the applied voltage. Okay, applied voltage here. How much of DC power supply you are giving? That is E. So that you can substitute here, 5 volts. R4, you know, value. R2 value also, you know. R3 also, you know. So apply all these values and you will get some VTH, Thevenin's voltage. Okay, so next, RTH. This is a formula to calculate RTH. It is Thevenin's resistance. RTH is equal to R2 into R4 by R2 plus R4. Plus R1 R3 by R1 plus R3. You know all the values, you can easily calculate the RTH value. And here VTH value, this you can substitute. RTH value, this value you can substitute. RM. RM means internal galvanometer internal resistance. So that we will come to know by taking this galvanometer. Okay. If I have given some galvanometer, easily you can calculate the internal resistance by using multimeter. Okay. So that is for this particular galvanometer. This is the internal resistance. So these values will vary. So according to the value what we are taking, R3. Okay. So which resistor value you are taking for R3, based on that all these values will vary. Okay. So whatever the value you are considering and whatever the galvanometer you are taking, so based on these two, your values will vary. So you can calculate IG, you will get some value. So this is the theoretical current that you have to substitute. You have to write here. So, for the R3 8K and whatever the galvanometer you are taking, for that some RM will be there. That is called internal resistance. Okay. So, based on that, you can calculate the current value. So, whatever the current value you are getting, that you write here. Okay. So, in terms of amperes or milliamperes. Now, we will verify what this galvanometer actually showing. So, that you can see by using this galvanometer that you have to write here. And these two values should be matches. It's not compulsory that you should get exact value, but approximately these two values should be equal. So like that, you can go for R3 is equal to 6K. When R3 is equal to 6K, you calculate current value. By using the same formulas, you will get some value here. And what the galvanometer is showing, that you can write here, these two values should be matches. So this is about case 2. In the case 2, it is unbalanced condition. In the unbalanced condition, we can use this bridge to measure the current values. Okay, so in the balanced condition, this bridge is used to find out the unknown resistance value. So this is about Wheatstone bridge experiment.